Come with us to a journey through time and culture. Immerse yourself in the beauty of human history and creativity. Join us as we embark on an unforgettable adventure. Discover the past, embrace the present, and inspire the future.
Mabuhay, art lovers and creative souls! Welcome to another exploration of the Artful Explorers. I am your host, Hanah Gabrielle, and we are here at Fort San Pedro.
Fort San Pedro, nestled along the scenic coastline of the Cebu, Philippines, stands as a living testament to the rich history, vibrant archipelago, built by the Spanish conquistadors in 1565. This triangular shape bastion served as a strategic defense outpost during the colonial era. Today, it welcomes visitors to step back in time and explore its well-preserved walls, quaint courtyards, and historical exhibits. As you wander through its passages, you can almost feel the echoes of the past, reminding us of the resilience and heritage that shaped the Philippines into what it is today. Fort San Pedro is not merely a fortress. It has a tangible connection to the enduring legacy of the Philippines' culture and historical tapestry.
The Basilica de Santo Niño, located in the heart of Cebu, Philippines, is a sacred sanctuary and an enduring symbol of faith and devotion. Constructed in the 16th century, this magnificent church houses the revered Santo Niño image, a precious relic brought by Spanish explorers in 1521. It is not only a testament to the enduring legacy of Christianity in the Philippines, but also a place where thousands of pilgrims and tourists gather to pay their respects and marvel at its intricate architecture, including its stunning facade and awe-inspiring interior. The Basilica de Santo Niño embodies a profound sense of spirituality, and its history is intertwined with the very essence of Filipino culture and faith, making it an essential pilgrimage site and a beacon of hope for all who visit.
Mabuhay, arts and craft lovers and creative souls! Welcome to another episode of the Artful Explorers, the ultimate destination for all things of art. And I'm your host, Beyonce Marie Yu, and together with me is Hanah Gabrielle Sinoval. We are on a mission to explore the boundless world of creativity. So what are you waiting for? Wait, grab your virtual passport, pack your curiosity, and let's set off another epic artist expedition together.
Entering the Santo Niño Museum feels like stepping into a sacred realm where history, art, and spirituality converge. It is like a transformative experience that immerses me in a world of profound significance. As I look around the artifacts, the way of history and spirituality envelops me, creating an atmosphere of solemnity and reverence. The pew chairs and dining table, which are very old, brings me back to the 16th century. The artifacts and religious treasures on display offers a glimpse into the rich heritage of the Basilica de Santo Niño and the cultural tapestry of our religion. Therefore, all I can say is that it was indeed a remarkable experience where it gives me and my groupmates a knowledge of the past and also the present, where we share real treasure.
Hi sir, so ang question is, what's the silbi o role sa mga museo o mga institution parihan din sa Basilica?
So ang role sa Basilica, Basilica Museum, there is ato as a Catholic, as a Filipino, ang role sa museum is to store and to pag-amping sa mga butang nga mga gihabilin sa ato ang mga ancestors nga mga utang. So importante kayo ang museum para makita pud sa lain nga mga henerasyon ang mga butang nga gihabilin sa ato ang mga ancestors kaniadto pa way back 1521. So makita nato diri sa basilika, dili lang sa museo, in general sa basilika gyud ang kaniadtong gidala ni Magellan ang luha ka, mga imahe. So, ang 500 years old images atong anlan, namely, ang imahe sa ato ang balaang batang Jesus, ang Santo Niño. Ang ikaduha, ang Ecce Homo. Ang Ecce Homo is a Latin word for behold the man. So, makita po na nato ang imahe sa Ecce Homo na sa opposite side sa original image sa Santo Niño. So, ang original image sa atong Santo Niño, mauna ang gilinyahan nato para pahalok for veneration. And then, in the opposite side sa ato ang simbahan is the Ecce Homo, the 500-year-old so image brought by Magellan way back 1521.
So, follow-up question, sir. Kanaunsa ang importance pagpahibaw sa mga next generation about sa mga tradition and culture?
So, ang importansya ani sa pagpahibaw nila na anaa pa o ni exist pa ang mga butang nga kaniadto, mga butang nga gibilin sa ato ang mga ancestors kaniadto. Ano importansya sa atong museum o sa institusyon sa Basilica. Daghang salamat.
The Archdiocesan Museum of Cebu is a cultural and historical treasure located in Cebu City, Philippines. Housed within the majestic, centuries-old structure of the Cebu Metropolitan Cathedral, this museum showcases a rich collection of religious artifacts, artworks, and historical relics. Visitors can explore the museum's galleries, which provide a comprehensive overview of the Catholic's faith, deep roots in the Philippines, as well as the region's cultural heritage. The museum's exhibits include priceless religious icons, vintage photographs, and archaeological finds that offer insights into the history of Cebu and its pivotal role in the spread of Christianity in the country. A visit to the Archdiocesan Museum of Cebu is a journey through time, allowing visitors to connect with the region's spiritual and historical past.
Good afternoon! So my question for you is, in your own observation, do you think the artifacts here in Cebu impacts the whole community in a good way or in a bad way?
Specifically in the Archdiocese of Cebu, since this is the only ecclesiastical museum and repository of all religious artifacts, I think it's a 99% that it enhances and grows the faith of the Filipino people, most especially those Cebuanos. No? Not only with Cebuanos, but for also our tourist visitors coming from the different countries.
So in addition sa iyang mga pangutana, Kuya, like unsa man ang ethical o cultural nga implikasyon sa collecting and trading sa mga art o mga artifact gikan sa lain-laing mga background?
Okay. Since the Archdiocese and Museum of Cebu, no, nahimugso was built 2006 under the name of the late Cardinal Ricardo Vidal, this museum also is to adopt also, not only adopt, but also to receive and safeguard all the religious artifacts, again, coming from the different parishes in the Archdiocese of Cebu. In terms of protection, in terms of preservation and conservation of those artifacts, it goes very thoroughly, and of course, we do scrutinize also the artifacts, if the artifacts belongs to the mid of 80s, even the late 50s, no? So the implications also for those coming from the parishes, they will also very gracious that they will see the artifacts that it is being reposited here, no? Even like 50s, 60s, no? They will be amazed, oh, there are some artifacts coming from their parishes, which they will find it here in the Archdiocese Museum of Cebu.
The various historical and cultural diversity of Cebu serve as a great source of inspiration for local artists. As a province faces the problems of growth, issues including urbanizations and environmental problems and cultural preservations are portrayed in the contemporary works. The art scene in Cebu has been profoundly influenced by the historical occurrence, including as the colonization, war, post-independence, nationalism, and current issues. They have helped to create a vibrant and diverse artistic environment that has remained an anchor in the history and the culture of the area, while also involving and adapting to the new times. And that's a wrap-up for another artistic adventure here in the Artistic Explorer. Always remember that every creative journey is a beautiful one. This has been Gino Paulo and us before us.
And I'm Angelic A. Bontilao.
I'm Beyonce Marie P. U.
I'm Francynne Blithe Baya.
I am Hanah Gabrielle C. Noval.
I'm Paula Abarquez.
I am Francynne Yzabella Pinili.
Now signing off.
Bye! Bye.